Y'all didn't think I was gonna upload today, did ya? Sorry that this video is going up late, but better late than never, you know what I'm saying? I'm having like terrible gas cramps. My gas cramps are even worse than my period cramps. Is this what labor feels like? Gas cramps are no joke. Anyways, hello Birch family. We're gonna be decluttering my highlighter drawer today. If you're new here and don't know what the heck is going on, one, I'm decluttering and getting rid of all of my non-cruelty-free products. Number two, I'm moving and I need to get rid of some crap anyway. Ugh. My coffee tastes like poop, but it's all I got today, so I'm forcing myself to drink it. Anyway, let's get started with this declutter. This is a Ciate Dewy Stick. It honestly is just like literal butter. Like, it's tacky and gross. It makes your skin look wet. I don't wear it that much because it's like gooey and sticky. So I'm gonna get rid of this one. Oh my gosh, there's something in my freaking eyeball. What the heck is in my eye? Ew, it's a hair. It's like a dog hair. Oh, did I get it? One time I had a hair in my eye and I pulled it out and I felt it come out from like behind my eye. Isn't that disgusting? I just needed to share that with you guys. So Stila is cruelty free. It's like this weird squishy putty highlighter. I like this because if I wear a highlighter to work, because it's like this putty texture, it stays on all day. So I'm keeping this one. I also have these Physician Formula Butter Highlighters. I love these. This is also like that weird putty feeling, but like the drugstore affordable version. I have this one, I have this white one, and I have this gold one. These are so beautiful. It has this weird like wet, oily feeling to them. Almost, but I love them. I love them so, so much. So I'm definitely keeping them, and Physician's Formula is cruelty-free. Yay. So I recently learned that Maybelline is not cruelty-free. I do have two of their highlighters. They are really good for the drugstore, but I'm getting rid of them because they're not cruelty-free. And honestly, I like the Physician's Formula ones a lot better. Okay, another one of my absolute favorite drugstore highlighters is this little palette from Flower Beauty. This one is so good. Look at that. Isn't that bomb? Like, this is crazy. This palette, if I didn't know better, I would think it was like really expensive, but it's not. Oh my god. I have these two. I actually used to really love these two, and they're very good highlighters. I honestly just like the Flower Beauty and Physician's Formula ones a lot more, so I'm gonna get rid of these even though they are really good. I also have a Milani highlighter. Is this the only one I have? Yeah, this is the only one I have, and it's good. I used to really like it, but I like the Flower Beauty one more. So I'm gonna get rid of it. Whoa. I'm doing so good. So this is the Essence Pure Nude Highlighter. This is one of my favorites. It's so affordable. This is a highlighter I will always, always have. I'm honestly surprised I haven't hit pan on it because I use it every single day. So I'll use this highlighter to just dust all over my face if I want like a glow from within, very subtle look, and just like, I love this highlighter because it's so versatile. You can get a very soft look or a very intense look. We're definitely keeping this. I have three Becca highlights in Opal, Champagne Pop, and what is the other one? Prosecco Pop, and I'm keeping keeping all three of them because they're amazing. This is the Ofra highlighter in Rodeo Drive. Ofra is cruelty free, in case you didn't know. This is one of the most intense highlighters I have. When people come and talk to you, they're gonna have to like squint and be like, is that you? I can't see. I only wear this on special occasions. I am going to keep it because it's the most intense highlighter I have. So I don't see Artist Couture on the Cruelty Free Kitty website. So this is like a loose powder highlighter. I also have this one from Kylie Cosmetics that is also a loose powder highlighter. I use this one and like this one so much more, and I do know that Kylie Cosmetics is cruelty free, so I'm gonna keep this one and get rid of this one. I have a MAC highlighter, and MAC likes to test on animals. So we're getting rid of that one. I also have another one back here that I'm gonna get rid of. I learned that Makeup Forever also likes to test on animals, so I'm gonna get rid of this one. Bobbi Brown likes to test on animals. Oh my gosh. Freaking animal testers, what's wrong with you? So I have a couple of ColourPop highlighters. This one in Flexitarian is one of those intense highlighters. Look at that. I love this highlighter so much. I use it all the time. Shebang! Shebang! Shebang, shebang. This one is in Lunch Money. This one is okay. I'm not in love with it, so because of that, I'm going to get rid of it. I used to love this highlighter. It is a more subtle highlighter. It reminds me of the Essence Pure New highlighter, so because of that, I'm gonna get rid of this one. Wow. This is the Argan Enlightenment Illuminizer. This is a little too oily for me, so I'm getting rid of it. This liquid Marc Jacobs highlighter I do like. This is in Do You. I really like this, so I'm gonna keep it. Back here, I have these little bitty, super cute mini Cover FX highlighters. These are the best liquid highlighters in my opinion. I think they are great. This is the first liquid highlighter I ever tried and I immediately became obsessed with it. You can mix them in with your foundation. You can put it on before foundation. You can put it on after foundation and powder and it doesn't mess up your makeup. They're the best. I have two highlighters from Wet n Wild. This one in Precious Petals is one of my favorites. I love this one so much more than this one, so I'm gonna get rid of this one. I have a liquid highlighter from Becca. I'm gonna keep it. I also have this Omrizi highlighter from Anastasia, and Anastasia is cruelty free, so I'm keeping this one. I don't know where this is from. I used to use this little palette all the time. I honestly don't use it anymore. There's not anything on here that tells me the brand, so because I'm not sure, I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of it. This is in the color Hustla Baby. I really like Fenty Beauty. I do like this highlighter. I think it's a really cool and different color, so I'm going to keep it. I love this little palette from ColourPop, but I don't wanna talk too much about it because they don't make it anymore. But I'm keeping it. This is one of my favorite drugstore palettes. If you want a highlighter with a bunch of different colors, a bunch of different textures, this is it. They have very subtle ones and they also have like really metallic ones in here. So I'm keeping it. Ew, there's like a toenail in here. What the heck? That's disgusting. These are all the ones that I'm going to be getting rid of because I don't use them or they test on animals, which is not cool. All right guys, thank you so much for watching. If you liked this video, make sure that you're subscribed to this channel. If you're already part of the Birch family, remember to stay weird and I'll see you in tomorrow's video. Bye! Bye.